Hey everybody, Brett Etheridge here, founder of Dominate Test Prep, and there have been a lot of changes in the standardized testing industry over the past couple of months, obviously in response to the coronavirus pandemic, where a lot of testing centers have been closed, and yet they recognize that you still have deadlines to hit. You're trying to finish up your applications. You want to get into graduate school, business school, law school in time to start classes in the fall, and you need to take this test. And so what they have done is they've created kind of the stopgap solution. Now, maybe they'll stick around long term. Maybe they'll make this a permanent solution down the road. We're talking about the here and now. And the here and now is you have the opportunity of taking your exam from the comfort of your own home. And while there are a lot of benefits to that, a lot of pros, right? If you're gonna balance the pros and cons, there are a lot of pros. It's comfortable. You know the environment, right? Probably a lot less anxiety because you're going to be just taking it from your home. Hopefully, the bathrooms are a little bit cleaner at your testing center. A little bit funny, but go ahead and clean your bathroom if it's not. Shorter commute. You literally just walk into your living room and there you are. You're at the test center, right? So lots of good things about the fact that they're giving you this opportunity, and yet kind of the one glaring con, the one major drawback that I see is what? What's the major difference between the standard test that everybody's been taking at the test center for years and years and years and this new online at home format, the fact that you are taking it at home? Okay, so that's obvious, but why would that be a negative? Because complacency can set in. Part of doing well is kind of building up this mental edge, this mental sharpness. And there's something to be said for getting up the morning of your exam, hopping into your car, driving to the test center, kind of building up mentally, emotionally, doing your pre-exam routine, whatever that is, and knowing that it is game day. Mentally, things happen when that's the case. And you are not going to have that experience unless you do some of the things I'm talking about to kind of recreate that experience. I know I experienced that firsthand. So a lot of you know I do CrossFit. And when I was first starting CrossFit, I go all in. I signed up for competitions right out of the gate, which was probably stupid. So I'd been doing CrossFit for a couple months, and I was in Bogota, Colombia at the time when I started CrossFit. And there was a competition at a different gym across town, and I signed up for it. But I wasn't familiar with the area, and so I did a lot of reconnaissance. I literally got in a cab, you know, several days beforehand, drove up there just to see how long it would take. I wanted to scout it out, get a feel for the environment. What was it going to be like, look like? Where do I go when I check in? All of those types of things. You know, the night before, I prepared my food in advance, made all my sandwiches and bars and drinks and had it all ready and laid out and in the refrigerator the night before. Got a good night's sleep, got up real early, did some pre-stretching, kind of did a morning routine, got there super early so I could stretch and get ready. And I had a great competition, right? I was mentally sharp. I was into it. I was locked in. It was game day. The butterflies were there, a little bit of anxiety, but I was ready. I knew what I was in store for. Had a great competition. Now, fast forward a few months, there was another competition at my local box. They call it a box in the CrossFit world, my local gym. And it didn't go quite as well. And I think a big part of it was because I didn't have that mental edge. And I can't really put my finger on what it was, but just knowing that I literally just had to walk 5 minutes out of my apartment door and I would be there. It was the gym I went to every single day. It was comfortable. It was familiar, right? I knew the people. And I didn't mentally shift gears and say, yeah, but it's not just a normal training day. When I got there the morning of, they had ropes and they had it all blocked off and they had lanes and they had all the stuff. It was tables that you had to sign in and register for. And it was different because it was a competition day. Mentally, though, I hadn't made that transition. And so that can happen to you with your standardized test. The danger is that because your home environment is so easy and comfortable and natural, that maybe you don't quite have that edge that you need to succeed. And so what I want to do is I want to kind of share three tips around that I think will really help you succeed and maximize your at-home experience, all right? So let's go ahead and dive in. And the first tip to maximize your at-home testing experience is you want to create as much as possible accurate simulations. By simulations, I mean practice tests. Practice tests are a huge component of preparing for your standardized test under any circumstances, right? But now your practice test can literally be in the same environment where you are going to take the real thing. So we can create a situation. We need to think about how we can create a situation that is going to be as much like the real thing as possible. Now, previously, I've often advised my students that maybe it's a good idea to go take your practice test, you know, at a library, for example, where there's a little bit of ambient noise, so you can kind of get used to that, kind of like in a testing center. It's not, you're not locked away in a room in a test center. It's not completely quiet. But in your home, we now have the opportunity of taking your practice test exactly where you are going to take the real thing. And that means I want you to fully prepare the area. I'm going to talk about this a little bit with a second point, but you need to know what are the requirements. What is expected of your testing environment? And I know if you read the website and all the rules and stuff like that, you need a completely clear workspace. You're not allowed to have anything else on the table. You're not allowed to have anything else in the background, right? They want to make sure you have to show them a 360-degree view of your room. They want to make sure there's not like a whiteboard set up behind the computer with all the formulas on it, right? That you're like cheating as you're taking your test. No. And so you can recreate that exact testing environment right there in your home well enough in advance that all of your practice can be done there. And by the way, not just your practice tests. I would suggest even your practice sessions. A lot of times we can fall into the habit of just kind of kicking back on the couch with our book, maybe our laptop, and we're doing some practice problems, but maybe the TV's on in the background, and we're reading, we're watching some videos, But now let's put ourselves in the real testing environment. Let's sit at the same table with the same chair we're going to use for the real thing. Clear out that environment, sit down and do our practice sessions that way, our practice test that way. And here's kind of a final hack for you. Here's just a really good tip. Think about one of the other things that's going to be going on, right? One of the things that is unique about the at-home experience is they're going to live proctor your exam, meaning they're going to have somebody who essentially takes over your computer. They're going to kind of hack into your computer, not hack in, that's probably the wrong way to say it. It makes you feel all weird about the experience. But the point is, it's like if you've ever done online IT and they say, hey, would you share your screen with me so I can help walk you through whatever problem it is? That's essentially what's going on. So they're going to be able to see you. They're going to be able to check in with you. If you have questions, if something happens, you can call on them. And so that's kind of a weird thing for a lot of people, right? That's certainly not happening during your practice test. So here's what you can do to prepare for it. When you sit down to do a practice test, why don't you set up a quick Zoom call with a friend or FaceTime in a friend while you're taking your practice test so that you have the little box open on your screen. You can literally see them. They're watching you while you're taking it, and you get used to that experience. Now, from your friend's standpoint, they don't want to sit there for 3 hours watching you take a test. So you can tell them to go about their lives, but maybe set an alarm every hour. They kind of check in with you, and all of a sudden you're taking your practice test and this little face pops up because they're checking in. Hey, how's everything going? You know, whatever. Get used to that. My point is, you want to recreate the testing environment as much as possible during your practice because you have the opportunity to do that to make it as accurate as possible. And that can only help you on test day. That brings me to point number two. Point number two for the at-home testing experience is to know thy enemy. This is a term you may have heard me use before, right? It's from The Art of War. It's this idea that the better, like the army or the general who knows the opposition the best, who surveys the battlefield in advance and puts him or herself in the best position strategically on the battlefield, who knows all the strengths and weaknesses of the opponent before even getting to the battlefield, who pre-thinks all of the possible contingencies and what am I going to do if this happens, and what am I going to do if that happens, and that's the idea of know thy enemy. That army, those generals generally win. And you can do the same thing for your standardized test. Now, yes, I am calling the GMAT, the GRE, the LSAT your enemy. So it's not really your enemy, but we want to pre-think it. And for the at-home experience, what that means for you is you need to go to the official website on whatever test you're taking and go to the page where it lists everything, all the fine details, all the fine print, all the stuff in italics about the at-home experience, and read it. and reread it and make sure there are going to be no surprises. Make sure I talked about kind of the testing environment. See what's expected of the testing environment. What about the scratch paper situation, right? I know, unfortunately, on the GMAT, at least as of the time of this recording, they're not allowing you to have external scratch paper. You have to use an online whiteboard. And so you should practice with an online whiteboard if that's how you're going to be taking the real thing. Now, maybe they're going to reverse that, maybe not. But if you're on the GRE, you're allowed to have laminated scratch paper, like a dry erase board. So go get your hands on some so you're practicing with that, right? They want to make sure you can erase it at the end of the exam for test security, right? The whole big thing they're trying to make sure with these online tests is test security, maintain the integrity, make sure people aren't cheating, make sure you're not taking answers, you know, outside and giving them to your friends. And so scratch paper is a big part of that. But what do they say about that? What do they say about the requirements, right? You want to do an actual walkthrough. Test the technology. There's always a link on the official sites. And I'll try to post some of those links in the notes below. But what are the technological requirements? And is there a link you can click on to test your software, make sure your microphone connects, make sure your video camera connects, make sure your speakers work, all of those types of things. Make sure you have the proper operating system, the right software. This is all part of knowing that enemy. And what are you going to do if different things happen, right? The contingency types of things. What happens if your dog barks? What are you going to, like, what if your family comes home while you're taking the test? Think about all these things. What happens if your internet glitches out? Now, they make allowances for technological failures. They'll let you cancel your score and they'll give you a voucher to retake it. But who wants to get an hour into taking this thing? Maybe you feel like you're doing well and all of a sudden your internet glitches out. If it were me, I would have my mobile hotspot primed up and ready on my phone so that if my main internet goes out, I can quickly tap back into my mobile hotspot and keep going. Yes, maybe I lose a couple of minutes, but at least I don't have to do this whole thing over again in the future. So this is what I mean by knowing thy enemy. Pre-think, make sure you know exactly what you're in store for, because that will help alleviate anxiety on test day. All right, that brings me to the third and final point. And I would say this is actually probably the most important, because it speaks to what I was talking about earlier with respect to kind of that mental edge, thinking about my CrossFit competition experience. And that is, you want to win the morning. I talked about how normally we have kind of like this built-in build-up, for lack of a better way of saying it, mentally, where you know it's game day, you know something's different about this day, you're ready to go, and you have that build-up as you're driving to the testing center and so forth, right? You're not going to have that, so we want to recreate that a little bit. And by the way, some of what I'm going to talk about here applies even if you're watching this and you end up taking it in a testing center anyway. So how can you win the morning? How can you get yourself kind of pumped up? Number one, it's going to have kind of three mini strategies inside this overarching strategy for you, is you want to take a cold shower, because that gets the blood flowing, right? So when you're showering the morning of your test, you don't have to, the whole thing doesn't have to be a cold shower, but literally at some point, just kind of crank it to cold, sitting there for like 10 seconds as long as you, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, as long as you can stand it, then put it back to hot, right? Even just that little boom, like gets the adrenaline going, gets the blood flowing to the brain. That's a great thing to do. Then go have a hearty, good, nutritious breakfast. And by the way, these first two points I just cited, we talked about on my podcast, episode 17 a few weeks ago. Go back, check that out. I'll put the link below. But episode 17 of the Dominate Test Prep podcast, I interviewed a doctor and he was talking about really nutrition for mental focus and clarity. But he also kind of gave the cold shower tip, which I think is a great one. But he also talked a lot about what to eat the morning of. You want a good, hearty, nutritious breakfast, lots of good fats, some carbs for the kind of the mental energy, right? Your brain burns fuel, lots of fuel. And you're going to be concentrating hard for 3 hours. So you want to make sure you have a full stomach, some good protein. Eggs are a great thing to eat the morning of, because I think the choline is the ingredient he mentioned in the eggs, is really good for brain function and concentration and focus. So if you're not an egg eater, just figure out some good fats, some good carbs, some good proteins the morning of, to make sure that you're locked in, you're ready to go, and have the energy you need to do well. And then the third one, this is kind of my tip for you, and this might be the most important tip of all, and that is dress up. When you get up the morning of, right, here's what you don't want to do. You don't want to say, oh, you're like, you yawn, oh, I guess I'm going to take the GRE today, the GMAT today. And you just kind of wander down, get a cup of coffee, and plop down in your pajamas, right, or you're wearing sweatpants, because we kind of perform how we feel. And how we feel if we're wearing our pajamas and our sweatpants is that, yes, we're very comfortable, but we're also comfortable. Does it make sense? We don't want to necessarily be real comfortable when we're taking a high-stake exam. So instead, let's dress up. Literally, wear a tie. I remember all of my exams in college, I would dress up. Now, people might have looked at me weird, but I did great in college, right? How you feel is how you end up performing. And there's lots of studies to this effect, too. This is not just something I made up. I got it from psychology textbooks that talk about you dress up, you wear a suit, you just perform different. Now, you don't have to wear a full-on suit. Don't go rent a tuxedo, but just dress up a little bit. Don't be comfortable in your pajamas or your sweatpants, right? Dress up a little bit because that will mentally trigger a different response, that mental sharpness. And by the way, here's kind of a fourth bonus tip for you along those lines. Remember I talked about how I drove and scouted out the CrossFit competition, that first one? A lot of times I'll encourage my students in a test center environment to go scout it out, drive there, see what the route is, kind of get a lay of the land. You don't need to survey your own living room, but here's what you can do. Hop in your car, the morning of your exam, drive around the block twice, pull back into your driveway, get out. Hey, I'm at the testing center. Walk in, sit down, and start your exam, right? Recreate that. Even just that little leaving your house, coming back in, kind of hits that reset button. It builds you up, gets you mentally sharp. Maybe you listen to some good pump-up music, whatever's going to get you going in your car as you're driving around the neighborhood, and then back into your house, and there you go. The point is, we want to connect mentally with the fact that something is different. And it can sometimes be difficult to do that at home, but hopefully, if you implement these three tips, these three strategies, certainly you want to practice as well as you possibly can in advance, but then know thy enemy, make sure there are no surprises on test day. And then the morning of, it's game day, it's go time. Do whatever you need to mentally build up so that you can dominate your exam. So there you go. Obviously, check out the podcast. I think that's a great episode, episode number 17, for some nutrition tips. Head over to dominatetestprep.com for the rest of what you need to do to dominate your exam, right? Even if you only have a couple of weeks, you know, people sign up for my courses all the time just a week or two before their exam and have great, great results, cramming as many videos and practice problems and worksheets as they can. So if you still need help with the other parts of your preparation, learning the content, learning the strategies, practice problems, head over to dominatetestprep.com. But I hope you have found this helpful, and here's what I would like to know from you. In the comments area below, I would like to know, what are you most worried about with respect to the at-home testing experience? Hopefully I've addressed some of it, but is there anything else you are concerned about, worried about, questions you still have about the at-home testing experience? Post them below. I would love to know what you're wrestling with, and I'll be happy to answer and provide some feedback on that. And then I'm very curious to hear how this experience goes, right? The GRE has been doing it for a little while. GMAT's about to do it. Obviously, you're probably going to be watching this well after, you know, they have fully, you know, been immersed. But what I want to do is I want to hear what the experience is like. So head back here, shoot me an email if you want, or post in the comments below, what was the at-home experience actually like? What were your nerves like? What was your mental preparedness like? How did you do? I would love to know all that because I'm very curious to hear how this online testing experience goes. So with that, I'll leave you to get back to your studying. If there's anything else I can do to help, don't hesitate to let me know so that you can go out and dominate your test.